In the past few days, we've got new insights into how the nation's central bankers reacted to the global economic meltdown of 2008. This with the release of the Federal Reserve Board's transcripts from that time. With more about all this is John Hilsenrath of the Wall Street Journal. He joins us from Washington. And so take us back, if we had amnesia, 2008. What's the setting where all these conversations are taking place?
The setting is it's a moment of crisis. And a period where Fed officials are constantly playing catch up, constantly trying to keep up with events that are spiraling out of control. There are moments when they feel like they're ahead of the curve, but there are many moments when they're clearly behind the curve.
So, I mean, hindsight's 20/20, but let's start looking at different characters here. After the collapse of Lehman Brothers, what's Ben Bernanke thinking?
Right after the collapse of Lehman Brothers, it's kind of his last moment of hopefulness that maybe they can escape this thing without a disaster. There's a meeting actually 2 days after the that Sunday, that fateful Sunday night when the government decided to let Lehman go. And Bernanke actually says in this meeting that, you know, maybe monetary policy, the level of interest rates is in the right place. They had kept them at 2%. Within a matter of days, everything changes. They're in the process of bailing out AIG. 36 hours later, Ben Bernanke and Hank Paulson go to Congress, and they say that the government has to step up and bail out the whole banking system. And within a matter of weeks, he's moving to slash interest rates. So, you know, Bernanke, that September meeting was really a great example of him playing catch up and not immediately recognizing the gravity of events that were in front of him.
Okay, how about Tim Geithner? He later goes on to be Treasury Secretary. What were his positions at the time?
You know, Tim Geithner is a very interesting character here. He spends a lot of time in these meetings sparring and jousting with the Fed's policy hawks, officials from regional Federal Reserve banks who are more worried about inflation than with the financial system stability. And Geithner spends a lot of time jousting with them. Frankly, you know, there's some moments here where he looks like he's behind the curve. Mm-hmm. There's a January 2008 meeting where Geithner gives his assessment of the financial system, and he says it looks like the process of healing has already started. He couldn't have been more wrong in that case.
All right, let's talk also about Janet Yellen, who's Fed chairman now. What was her behavior then? What can we glean from that going forward and how she might behave?
You know, one of the things that got Yellen this job was a sense that she had very good judgment, that in 2007, when we looked at earlier transcripts, she was one of the first people to say, hey, we have some real problems in this housing market. We know from their decision since 2008, she's pushed very hard to keep interest rates low and hasn't been too worried about inflation. These 2008 transcripts, I think, confirm this sense that the lady has pretty good judgment. She was usually one of the people in the room saying that she was concerned that the financial system was in grave danger.
All right, John Hilsenrath from the Wall Street Journal, thanks so much.
Thanks a lot.